Good afternoon all. Today is the last day of the webinar, and I won't still call it last of the webinar. You all can connect me. You all have my numbers. Whenever you want, I'm there to help you out. And the idea behind to start this internship was that at least I can give 1 hour to the budding lawyers who wants to come to the profession. And secondly, see, juniorship is not all about what I will say, ki go and work in the office. But I would say it is always the attaining the knowledge. Whatever, how much knowledge you can gain from. You can gain from books also. You can go to the library, court, and any other lawyer, and you can get the same thing. But because of the pandemic, the situation was such that all are locked up in the rooms. And even the courts are, even if they are working, they are working for only important matters which are very of urgent nature. In this situation, this technology came very handy, and I would tell all of you that I am thankful to all of you also who took out their time. Though I can understand because of pandemic, there is lot of frustration, depression, lot of things. But then I have one thing I would like to tell you. If you see lockdown as an opportunity, then really it's an opportunity. How you want to subsume the situation? I have seen this situation to connect with so many people. I do my webinars on every Saturday, which you can connect later on with Vandana and me, and you can join every Saturday 9:30. Since last September, I'm doing that, and I have done more than 50 webinars. I'm very happy that in the process of taking up this webinar, I got lot of knowledge. So when I got connected with you, I was so happy that somewhere in Uttar Pradesh, somewhere in Gujarat, I'm able to meet all of you online. Otherwise, it would not have been possible. So I'm thankful to all of you. So let's go to today's subject. Today I would like to take the types of the panchanama. Panchanama is very important part of the criminal practice. So if you, whenever you are going to run a criminal trial, you will always find 2-3 panchanamas, maybe 5. So 5 I will discuss here, but not in all the cases you will find all the 5 panchanamas. But normally you find these panchanamas, and it is very important that you know what are these panchanamas. The first very popular is spot panchanama. Now, one thing I would like to tell you, the spot panchanama, the name suggests you have to go to the spot, to the place of the incident. So the officer, investigation agency, police constable, they go to the spot and they see all the situation there. They may write the directions also, east, west, or what is the position. If it is a robbery or dacoity, then they will see which house is in which condition, how things are lying here and there. They will find out everything, and they mostly in spot panchanama, they don't take anything in possession. And if they take in possession, they will draw another panchanama, that is next panchanama which I will discuss, seizure panchanama. Now, before we go to the panchanama thing, I would like to tell you what is panchanama. As the name suggests, Hindi mein kehte hai ki pancho ne likha hua details. So here there will not be punch, but we call them punch. There will be independent witness. They will not be somebody from the police station. They will not even be relatives of the accused or complainant. They will be independent. It may be neighbors. It may be somebody who is going through that place and he just witnessed that incident. It may be an accident case where people are just around there. So they may also be a punch. So normally the police takes the people who are independent and have no relation with the crime. So this is from the complainant side, also from the accused side, and those who are not interested. So panchas are very important witness in the criminal trial. So spot panchanama is something which is done on the spot. It will be direction, the way, anything, whatever line, the situation at the spot. See, suppose we go to marriage, we tell there were 1,000 people, there were mandaps, there were garlands. The same way, if it is a spot panchanama accident case, they will say there were cars, there was a road divider, there was a signal, there was a blood lying on the road. So it may be anything. There is a broken glasses, because of the accident case. So spot panchanam is very simple, is a spot. So it will be about leading you to the incident place. Now next is seizure panchanama. Seizure itself says that they are seizure, taking away something. They are taking in possession. They are seizing something. Now seizure panchanama, whenever the investigation officer done, it is very important that he takes two independent people. Now these panchas, whatever they say in the court, will also make a difference to your case. So take panchanama as a very important piece of paper. So whenever you get panchanama, do read it properly from the trial line of action, because whatever is written in panchanama and the punch comes before court and says everything like that, same whatever written in panchanama, there is a higher chance of conviction to the accused in criminal trial. So always see seizure panchanama. If it is again accident case, murder case, or suicide case, so they will of course do the spot panchanama. They will also seizure. If it is a suicide case, they may seize something. It may be dupatta, it may be something, whatever. I don't want to say anything, it's too negative. And if it is a murder case, if the accused is arrested, what they will do? They will ask him with what weapon you have committed the crime. So they may also seize the weapon lying. Sometimes weapons are lying there only, and the accused left. Of course, they won't be there at least where they have committed the robbery or crime, anything. But there may be something which they have to seize. It may be clothes also. They may take the clothes of the person who is expired. So from the body, they will take it to the hospital and they will seize. So it is always about the seizure. Always, whatever they are seizing. It may be nothing has happened. It may be simple case of the husband and wife also, but some scuffle took place. And glasses have broken, there are utensils lying in here and there. There may be something, whatever they will seize, they will do it as a panchanama. Now next is inquest panchanama. Inquest panchanama is about the details of the death body. See, inquest panchanama is completely, normally, it is done at the at the hospitals when the body is taken in the possession, because whenever they find a body first, because nobody can certify that a person is dead or alive except doctors, medical officer. So the body is sent to the medical officer, that is the government hospital. Normally, if not available, then private hospital. In such situation, always remember, whenever they go to the medical officer, that is doctor will write, give some information which will be written in the, will be written or reflected in the inquest panchanama. Normally, this is also because it is a inquest panchanama, it is, will be about always a death. So it will be suicide, murder, accident, whatever, in what condition. It may also be what is the injury. They may write a few things about the medical history also. Whatever they can find out. There may be some little bit of history. If there is an accident on the road and somebody has taken that person to the hospital, they may also write an inquest report who has brought that particular person to the hospital if police has not brought. So inquest panchanama also you must read. So whenever you are doing a criminal trial, always remember that you should do all these things. You should read it. Normally, people ignore panchanama. No, panchanama is something which can turn the criminal trial from conviction to acquittal. If there is some difference in the witness statement and the panchanama. So this is very important. Always remember, panchanama is one of the important part. Now, next is memorandum panchanama. In Maharashtra, we call it Nivedan panchanama also. Now, when memorandum panchanama is there, see, memo of written arguments. Normally we write, jab bhi hum log arguments submit karte hai court ke saamne, memo of written arguments. That is memorandum of written arguments. Or memo of appeal when you go to high court. So always remember ki memorandum panchanama is always when somebody is making a nivedan. Suppose it is an accused. He committed a crime. Let's take it a murder case. And he is arrested. So he will say, I have done a murder during the investigation with this weapon. So police will definitely ask, where is that weapon? He will say, I have thrown this weapon. Maine kahin par bhi fek diya hai. तो या कहीं छुपा दिया मैंने वो वेपन, कैसे आपने किया है, अगर आपने जहर दिया है तो कैसे दिया है, तो दिस ऑल थिंग्स विल कम इन दी पंचनामा. सो मेमोरी, तो वॉट एवर द अक्यूज सेज एंड सबमिट्स बिफोर द इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑफिसर, इट विल बी रिटन इन दी एज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ स्टेटमेंट कि अक्यूज निवेदन करते हुए, मराठी में बोलते हैं, तो एक्यूज सबमिट कर रहा है तो उसका वो जो निवेदन है वो दो पंच के सामने होगा, दैट इज द मेमोरेंडम पंचनामा. नाउ नॉर्मल देखो, मेमोरेंडम पंचनामा इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम द एंगल आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू कि नॉर्मली जो पुलिस के सामने स्टेटमेंट होता है, इट इज नॉट एडमिसिबल इन द कोर्ट एज इट इज, देर हैज टू बी डिपोजिशन ऑफ द सेम स्टेटमेंट. बट मेमोरेंडम पंचनामा में जो भी आपने बोला है, अक्यूज ने जो भी सबमिट किया है, and these two people, even if accused बाद में पलट जाए, लेकिन even if both these people जिनके सामने ये पंचनामा record किया है, these both panchas come before the court, even one panch, why two panchas are taken? Because one is not traceable, then two panchas. So if both these panchas come before the court and they say this memorandum of panchanama was recorded in front of us, accused said so and so, he has hidden the weapon here and there, then this memorandum of panchanama is admissible in the court. There are judgment which said memorandum panchanama can be admitted even by the investigation officer, but of course there has to be chain of circumstances and other related documents and the other cogent evidence as well. So this is also very important. So memorandum panchanama is one of the I would say important panchanama in criminal trial, which can again turn the criminal trial into from conviction to acquittal. Now next is arrest panchanama. As the name denotes, very simple arrest ke bare mein hai panchanama. So whenever somebody is arrested from his home or from outside, from the airport, sometimes people are out of India. So if they are having some bags with them, they are having some golds, so they will make an arrest panchanama. Police will and it is now mandatory that police informs the relatives. Agar relatives nahi available to uske dost. They have to inform. तो अरेस्ट पंचनामा में अगर कोई भी नहीं अवेलेबल तो उसके लॉयर को भी इन्फॉर्म करता है, इफ ही सेज कि मेरा लॉयर है तो इन अरेस्ट पंचनामा ऑलवेज रिमेम्बर कि वो उनको पूछेंगे कि आपका कौन है, रिलेटिव कौन है, रिलेटिव नहीं तो दो मित्र परिवार कौन है, आपका दोस्त कौन है, तो ऑलवेज इन अरेस्ट पंचनामा. देन सेकेंडली इफ ही इज वेयरिंग सम गोल्ड और वॉट एवर वॉच वॉलेट जो भी उनका होगा वो सारा अरेस्ट पंचनामा में लिखा रहेगा. मे बी इज हैविंग मोबाइल्स, तो मोबाइल फोन वो सब अरेस्ट पंचनामा में जब्त करके रखा जाएगा, एंड जब भी वो रिलीज होगा या उसकी फैमिली आएगी, इट विल बी हैंडेड ओवर. इट ऑल डिपेंड्स ऑन इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑफिसर, बट नॉर्मली दे हैंड इट ओवर अनलेस दैट मोबाइल इज रिलेटेड टू द क्राइम, दैट कैश विद हिम और एनी क्रेडिट कार्ड डेबिट कार्ड इज रिलेटेड टू द क्राइम. अदरवाइज एज अ लॉयर इवन यू कैन बी अलाउड टू टेक दैट इन योर कस्टडी, प्रोवाइडेड द अक्यूज अरेस्टेड पर्सन अलाउज यू टू टेक दैट. सो दिस वर टोटल 5 पंचनामा. The subject is very wide, but even at the internship level, if you know there are 5 types of panchanama in criminal trial, so it is more than enough. So this was all about. Now we will move ahead to another segment that is very important, reading by Rohini today. Rohini, unmute yourself.
हेलो मैम
जस्ट अ मिनट मैं शेयर कर रही
हूँ.
एक मिनट मैं ट्राई करती हूँ शेयर करने का, रुकिए. हाँ रोहिणी आप है ना, यहाँ से पढ़िए. Disability of dying declaration, just a minute. Dying declaration is the statement made by a person. यहाँ से आप start कीजिए please.
Okay. Dying declaration is the statement made by a person as to the cause of his death or as to the circumstances of the transaction resulting in his death. In Section 32, Clause 1 of the Indian Evidence Act, the only statement that is given just before the date is dying declaration. Also, the statement that is given before and which explains the cause of death is also the dying declaration. A person who is conscious and knows that death is about to happen can make a statement about the reason of his or her death will be admissible in the court. The word dying declaration explains the word itself. It means a written or verbal statement in relevant facts made by the person who is about to die or is dead. It is the statement of person who knew the cause of his death or of the circumstances of his death. It is said that a man will not meet his maker with the lying on his mouth. Nemo mortuus praesumetur mentari. In our Indian law, it is a fact that it is believed that a dying man can never lie or truth sits upon the lips of a dying man. Gesture and signs forms. Gesture and signs can be dying declaration even when the victim does not speak a word. The apex court stated that the evidentiary value of the gesture and signs will depends on the certain facts like who recorded the statement, what are the gestures, what were the question asked, were simple or not, etc. Gesture can be difficult to interpret, but this does not mean that the accused can roam freely after hurting someone. If the victim is not able to speak, gesture or sign can be taken as an evidence. In Nirbhaya case 2013, a bench of Justice Deepak Mishra, R. Bhanumati and Ashok Bhushan said a dying declaration should not necessarily be made by words or in writing, and it could be through gestures. Not just words, but even gesture can be made admissible in the court now. Question answer form. Dying declaration should be question and answer form. If the dying declaration is not in question answer form, it was held that it cannot be discarded for the reason alone. The statement can be recorded in the narrative way. Also, it is not mandatory to record it in question answer form. But it is always best to record in the question answer form as that will make the evidentiary value of the dying declaration more. Fitness of the victim should be examined. While recording the statement of the victim, it is very important to examine the health of the victim. It can be possible that he is making stories in the presence of drugs. Given judicial magistrate should satisfy himself that the victim is in fit condition to give a statement. A certificate should be obtained by the judicial magistrate from the doctors examining the victim. This certificate can prove in court that the statement given was in fit condition and it is true. If the circumstances do not permit attendance of the medical officer, then judicial magistrate can record the statement without the medical certificate, but judicial magistrate should provide the reason why considered it indivisible for a doctor's attendance. Who should be record the dying declaration? If the dying declaration is recorded by the magistrate, then it will hold more evidentiary value than any other dying declaration. Doctors and police officer are also authorized to record the dying declaration if the magistrate is not present, but sometimes the situation arises where dying declaration recorded by the magistrate can be questioned. For example, if the magistrate records it even when the doctor does not approve the victim medically fit, in this situation, the evidentiary value of the dying declaration can be questioned. The court always looks into the certain things to decide the value of the statement. The court always seeks if the victim was mentally fit while giving the statement. If the victim is not fit at the time of giving statement, then that statement won't be hold any value. Confusion can occur while recording dying declaration as anything can affect its evidentiary value. It should be taken with precautions and keeping minds in the following points. First point, the victim should be mentally fit to given statement. A medical certificate should be given by the doctor about her health. Second, a doctor and the police officer can record the statement, but it is best if the magistrate records it. In 2013, Delhi gang rape, three dying declarations of Nirbhaya were recorded. The first was recorded by the doctor when she was admitted to the hospital. The second was by SDM, during which she gave exact detail of the crime. And third one was recorded by a metropolitan magistrate and was mostly by gesture. In this case, all three dying declarations were recorded, but that one recorded by the magistrate was important. And the court did accept the dying declarations recorded by the magistrate, even when it was in gesture and notes. In Kushal Rao versus State of Bombay, the Supreme Court of India accordingly states that the court must be satisfied that the deceased was mentally fit to make the statement, and victim had the opportunity to observe and identify the accused. The victim should not be making the statement under any influence. Also, Supreme Court of India held that once the court is satisfied that the dying declaration is true, the conviction can be upheld and there is no need for further corroboration. If the dying declaration is recorded by the medical officer or police officer, it should be attested by one or more person that is present there. Language of the statement. As far as possible, the statement should be recorded in the language of the declarant or the court language. The court cannot discard the dying declaration on the basis of the language. It can be recorded in any language, even if the deceased made statement in Urdu, Hindi, Punjabi languages. It was held that statement could not be discarded on the ground of language alone or on the ground that it was recorded in Urdu. Where the statement was in Urdu and the magistrate recorded it in English, but the precaution was taken in explaining every statement to the deceased by another person. It was held that the statement was the valid dying declaration. Points to remember. Dying declaration can be recorded in any language. Second, if the statement was in another language than one which a magistrate recorded, then precautions should be taken. The court cannot reject or discard the dying declaration on the sole grounds of language. In Biju and Joseph versus State of Kerala, it was held by the court that merely on the ground that the statement of deceased was in her own language cannot be vitiated the dying declaration. It was stated by the High Court of Kerala. Assuming that the deceased gave her statement in her own language, the dying declaration would not be vitiated merely because it was recorded in a different language. We bear in mind that it is not unusual that courts record evidence in the language of the court. Even when witnesses depose in their own language, judicial officers are used to the practice of translating the statements from the language of the parties to the language of the court. Such translation process would not upset either the admissibility of the statement or reliability. Multiple dying declarations. Supreme Court of India held that multiple dying declaration can be relied upon without corroboration if there is a consistency in all dying declaration. If all the dying declarations are similar to each other, then it can be admissible. But if the dying declaration is different from each other, then the court will examine the fact of the case or can examine the statement of other witnesses to ascertain the truth of the case. The statement of the deceased should match the facts of the case. It is very important to understand the nature of the dying declaration. Points to remember in multiple dying declarations. First, consistency in all the dying declarations should be there. Second, if all dying declaration does not match, then the court will examine the facts, the case with the dying declaration or examine the witnesses. An exception to the death, an exception of death not necessary. Under English law, okay, 1 minute.
No problem.
In Kushal Rao versus State of Bombay, in this said the importance of dying declaration and what is the right process to record it. In this case, if the dying declaration is recorded in question answer form, if the medical certificate is given by the doctor, if it is recorded by the authorized person, then it is admissible and reliable. If there is a multiple dying declarations, then court looks into the all these points to see which dying declaration holds more evidentiary value. The Supreme Court has held that multiple dying declaration can be relied upon without corroboration if consistency is maintained throughout. Otherwise, the courts would have to examine the statement of other witnesses to ascertain the truth in criminal trial. An exception of the death not necessary. An expectation of death not necessary. Under English law, the victim should not be under any expectation of death. Evidence Act has taken this law from English law. If the statement has been made even when no cause of death had arisen from also statement will be relevant. It is not important to at all that the statement recorded should be just before the death of the victim. In Pakala Narayan Swami versus Emperor, it was held that the letter given by the deceased to his wife before going to the place where he was killed was relevant. The court said that the statement made must be at any rate near death or the circumstances of the transaction explaining his death is relevant under Section 32 of the Indian Evidence Act. In this case, the court stated that dying declaration can be any statement that explains the cause of death or the circumstances of the transaction explaining his death. Hence, statements as to any of the circumstances of the transaction which resulted in the death would be included.
Rohini, stop here.
Your fire as dying declaration.
Rohini, stop.
Okay,
stop.
Ma'am.
Thank you. Well done.
Okay, ma'am.
By reading this dying declaration, you all must have got an idea what is actually dying declaration. See, dying declaration is the last thing when a person dies, and whatever he speaks, it is always believed that whenever a person dies, he will try to speak the truth. He will never involve anybody's name in the case. So always remember that whenever a person dies, it is said in the law that he will not die with his maker, that is God, Ishwar, with the lie on his tongue. So this is the importance of the dying declaration, that he will never lie. So dying declaration is a very important piece of evidence, and it need not be proved by any independent witness. But normally, as we have seen, doctor, investigation officer, independent people, and the magistrate record. But the most important part is the magistrate recording the dying declaration. But sometimes there is no time. Sometimes doctor may not be available. Sometimes magistrate may not be available. So whenever whoever is near to that person, his statement by maybe gesture also. The same will also be understood as a dying declaration. So it's a very glitch situation which can be decided on a particular case. I'm sorry. Now with this, our today's session ends. I'm open for any questions, if any. You all can unmute yourself. Any question, Anshika? Please.
Yeah, hi, ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Can I see you?
Yes, just a minute, ma'am.
Yeah. Internship mein aap log on nahi rakhte ho, main kaise dekhungi?
Good afternoon, ma'am. First of all, I would like to thank you. This was really a good session. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Welcome.
Ma'am, I just had one doubt regarding memorandum panchnama. Ma'am, yes. That isn't it contrary to section 162, if I'm not wrong, of CRPC?
You are right.
Which says that statement.
There is an exception. Read 25, 26, 27 of the evidence section. This is an exception.
Okay. So, ma'am, can it be like this? Thank you, ma'am. Can it be like this every time whenever police investigates the accused, there can be two witnesses and then police can submit this report? This panchnama report in front of the court.
Along with the charge sheet.
And I'm just one more question, ma'am.
Examined. This panchas will be. It's not that the panchas will not be examined.
Okay.
They are speaking before a panch. These two panchas will be examined. It's not that it is like apparently it will be accepted. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Just one more question, ma'am. What is the evidentiary value of this panchnama? Like under what section of CRPC or Evidence Act? Are these admissible?
See, you have
this
to read
Panchanama
report. If you read 26, 25, 26, 27, read it. You will find the, all the sections there. And I wanted to tell all of you today, the one act I would like all of you to read, that is Evidence Act completely. It is completely exhaustive one and you will know everything. CRPC, IPC and the Evidence Act. And if you read Evidence Act, you will know how to run the trial. Procedure, criminal procedure code is procedure. It is about procedure. And IPC all about the crimes committed.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am.
Okay. Now I'll hand over for vote of thanks. Soumya, you can unmute yourself.
Hope I'm audible, ma'am.
Yes, you're audible.
Good afternoon to respected ma'am and all gathered here. I'm Soumya Pachauri, pursuing DLLB honors from University of Allahabad. In the beginning, I would like to thank Vandana ma'am for again giving me this chance to present vote of thanks. Ma'am, I would like to start with a quote by John Locke. The end of law is not to abolish or restrain, but to preserve and enlarge freedom. For in all the states of created being capable of law, where there is no law, there is no freedom. Anita Bafna, ma'am, I would like to thank you for providing me with an invaluable learning experience. I have gained much practical knowledge about the legal system. I particularly enjoyed to learn stages of criminal trial, Section 41 and 41A of CRPC. Provisions related to rape and 10,000 hours plan. Ma'am, it was an excellent learning experience and it allowed me to confirm my interest in pursuing a career as a judicial officer. Lastly, I'm going to dedicate a quote to you, ma'am, that the art of teaching is the art of assisting discovery. Thank you so much, ma'am. Have a great day.
Thank you all. Thanks, everybody. Thank you for being with me and we will continue our journey in future too. Thank you so much.